Good morning, hello everybody, welcome back to my video. We have a Bichon here and she's getting a haircut. She is a little bit messy, so we need to polish her up. Okay, let's do it. I'm going to use day number 4 on the body. 3, I think. She's getting old, so not much fur. Yeah, she's getting old. So 3 on the body, a little bit of a fluffy leg, and a Bichon head. If we could get the knots out, if not, then yep, then you have no Bichon head. Here, yeah, she has plenty of knots. Hey, okay. Okay, I'm just gonna brush out the head. Bichon is the kind of breed that you need to do a lot of work. It's a high maintenance dog breed. If you consider to have a Bichon, it's either you do a lot of work at home or you send them to the groomers regularly. Yeah, brushing prior to the bath will help to detangle the fur first. Well, big head, big hole here. Well, I don't even think I want to keep a big head for her. She doesn't come regularly, that's the problem. It's good that she can relax while I'm brushing. Okay. This is just a brush out before the bath. Hello. Yes. So all the tangles, mainly all the tangles are brushed out. How to shave this part? It's too matted to the skin. So, and this part, if I brush it too much, I don't think she'll like it. She's an elderly dog. And we're just gonna do a number 3 on her body and then she will be into the bathtub. Oh, very long nails. Probably with the nails, it's probably 3 months before the last time she came in. With a Bichon, if you want the head to be like a Bichon head, every 6 to 8 weeks. Okay, now the paw. If we do the paw, actually, let me wash it first before we do the paws. It's a bit dirty. Okay, the ears. Yeah. Okay, off we go. Yeah. Okay, you're ready to go for your bath? Yeah? Okay. Okay. Very nice, very fluffy. Very clean. All white. Yeah. Okay, let's start. Okay, now the paws are clean after me to clean the paws and the hair off the paws. Before the bath, the paws are too oily for me to get down to the skin area. Oh, I missed a nail. Okay, the other day, 2 days ago, 3 days ago, I took my dogs for the lacto vaccine. Apparently it's been affecting our city areas. There's already like 11 cases, death cases. I think it's, they said it's caused by recently we have a rat plague. Sounds really horrible. But yes, it's caused by rodent urine. Well, it's not my area, not this area. However, I thought, because I come into contact with a lot of dogs every day, so I encourage all my customers to get that vaccine, and I took mine for the vaccine as well, even though we're not the area to worry for. However, just in case, since you know, my profession do come across with a lot of dogs.
My camera's out of battery, so it will be charging. It's charging now. So I'm filming on my iPad. Unfortunate things to happen when you're just about to finish the dog. With no battery, so we're just gonna film with the iPad first. So I was saying that the lacto test, the vaccine, I need to go back 3 weeks later to get the second shot, and then they are fine. Because I do have a lot of possums in our backyard, and possums are rodent as well. back, just with a little bit of battery left, but still at least I think I can get through the head. See, this part is very bold. Okay. Let's do the eye area, just corners of the eyes, get rid of the tear stain. Lowering table. There's a big hole here and there's a big hole there. So we're just gonna use the fur from the sides to cover it up. So, you know, if you don't look closely, look from further away, still a big hole round head. Otherwise, if you're gonna
cut the hair from the sides, then it's going to be very holy. Can you see a big hole here? Okay. Now, this part, yeah, not much hair to support the top. Okay, we're done. Lucky! Yoo-hoo! Okay.